Hey guys, welcome to the 724 challenge. For those of you that are just now getting started, you need to go back to week one. I would suggest for you to start in week one. Listen to the welcome video. Go through week by week because there are some important things that you're going to miss. If you just jump all the way to this week, you don't want to do that. You want to go back to week one. If you have any help, if you have any questions, concerns, or anything like that, reach out to me. I'm available to you. My name is Anjanette Curry. I am the owner of PPS Financial Coaching and Services, and I have decided to do the 724 challenge, in which we are striving to get a 700 credit score in 24 weeks. So this week, we are in week nine. So week nine, we're going to talk about start saving for your dream. So week one, you know, we had worked on working on your credit, sending letters to the credit bureau. Week two, we talked about, you know, how to construct the letters, who to send it to. Week three, we talked about what you're doing when you're waiting on the letters and things like that. So week four, we talked about when we got the letters back. We talked about once you get the letters back, what to look for, how to read the letters and things like that. Then we talked about how to send the actual letters to the dispute company. So you have to send a letter to the credit bureaus, and then you have to send a separate letters to the collection agencies, and then your financial institutions like hospitals and things like that. So this week in week nine, we're going to talk about saving for your dream. So most of you, I think, wanted to buy a house. This is very important. You said that you want to try to get in a house this year, or maybe in the next couple of years, you want to try to be in a house. So one of the things is saving money. There are entities that you have to pay for so as with a house. That is down payment, earnest money. Sometimes you have to put down earnest money when you sign a contract to let the contract person, to let the seller know that you are serious and you're not trying to pull that contract. And that's to hold you in the contract, to keep you from trying to walk away, because if you cancel the contract, then you lose the earnest money. So that just holds you into that contract to keep you from canceling it, because they're holding that house for you because it's under contract. And so, and that's why you have to put down earnest money. Another thing is home insurance. You have to buy home insurance when you buy a house. That is part of the closing costs. They want to make sure that you're able to purchase that home insurance. And a lot of times, before you sign the closing paperwork, they want you to get home insurance before you sign the closing paperwork. So remember that. And then any other fees that you may occur. So you want to have the money for that. You don't want to get your credit straight and then try to go and buy a house, and then you don't have the money to put down as a down payment. You don't have earnest money. You don't have anything to help you with that, and then you have to wait another year or so to get that money. Typically, between $10,000 and $20,000 is what you need. I always tell my clients to save at least $10,000 to $20,000. That way, if anything comes up, you got the money and you don't have to wait for it, and you won't have to prolong the home buying process. Also, if you want to purchase your dream car, you got to have down payment. It depends, you know, it's better. You get a better interest rate if you can provide a down payment. So you may want to save about $3,000 to $5,000 if you're trying to buy a $50,000 to $60,000 car, which is, you know, sometimes it's more than that. A dream car, we're talking about the luxury cars, like the Lexus, the BMWs, the Mercedes, the Range Rovers. We're talking about those cars, and those cars could go up to $100,000 or more. So you want to have a good and stable down payment, so that way if they do ask for a down payment, you got it. So you need to save about $5,000 of a down payment if you're trying to purchase a luxury car. Business. With a business, there are startup costs. You don't want to prolong that if you don't have the money to start business. A lot of us have dreams and we want to pursue those dreams, but we don't have the cash to start the business. So now you have a chance. Since we're in the 724 challenge, we are creating streams to save money so that way when you do want to branch out and start your own business, you got that and you don't have to wait. Weddings. A lot of guys are planning their weddings. So it's good to save towards a wedding instead of trying to charge your wedding expenses on your credit cards. You don't want to go into a lot of debt getting married because after the marriage is over, you still have to live. And you don't want to be struggling after the marriage, after you get married, because that puts a lot of stress on the marriage. And we do know in divorces, I think financial strain is like the number one cause of divorces outside of infidelity. So you don't want to put that on your spouse. You don't want to put that on yourself. So it's best to go ahead and start saving the money so that way you don't put yourself in a financial strain. Family vacations. Now with COVID, it's part of our lives. Everybody's, this summer is coming up. People are saying, look, I'm tired of it. I'm going to live my life. I want to go on vacation. So people are planning dream vacations with their family because we know, hey, a lot of people are losing their lives. We don't know when the next family member is or when we're going to get that phone call about our family member or somebody that has transitioned. So we're trying to live our lives, and part of living our lives is going on dream vacations. These are vacations that can cost up to $5,000 or more. So you want to save money. Vacations should not be charged on credit cards, people. So if you're charging your vacations on your credit cards, then you're not living, okay? You're putting yourself in debt, and you don't want to do that. So the best thing to do is plan your vacations a year or two out and then save towards that vacation, okay? So now you're working on your credit. You're getting some things removed off your credit. We've done that. Your credit score is rising, right? Okay. So you paid that $1,000 and you're putting that $1,000 to work through either self-lender or you went through your bank and opened a Credit Starter loan, or you got a secured credit card, right? So we're working on increasing our credit. And so now it's time to start saving for that dream. So we want to do baby steps, and we're doing it in the right order, and we want to do these steps in the right order. So the best thing to do is now that you're working on your credit and you see some increases and things are happening, go ahead and start saving towards that dream. So when you do get ready, you got everything in order, guys. I'm giving you all this for free. All you have to do is just follow the steps. So this week in week nine, you got to have a game plan. So we're working on our game plan in week nine, okay? So the first thing you're going to do is decide how much money you're going to need for whatever dream you have. So if it's a house, you need to know, okay, I want to get a $250,000 house. I want to get approved for a $250,000 house. What would be my closing costs? What would be my estimated closing costs? Because you can kind of estimate that. You can kind of estimate your taxes. You can kind of estimate your down payment. You can kind of estimate your fees, your insurance, and things like that. So if you want to get approved for a $150,000 house, go ahead and calculate those costs, your closing costs. You can talk with a loan company, a bank, a lender, a bank lender. They can help you with that. Real estate agent, they can help you with that. They can kind of go in and kind of help you calculate things like that. So that way you can start saving your money. So when it's time for you and you got that credit score, that 700 credit score, you got the money saved and you can go ahead and transition. And it'll be a smooth transition instead of you having to pull back to save money. You already got the money, okay? So we don't want nothing to come in and hinder our process. We want to go ahead and take care of everything with the steps that we're in the 24 weeks. That's why I'm saying 724, because I'm giving you guys step by step. And if you go through the steps by the 24 week period, which is 6 months, you got everything is in line. So you've completed all the steps, and all you have to do is just wait and save the money that you need to save, and then transition. It's amazing, okay? So what you're gonna do, again, decide how much money you need. You're gonna calculate that, calculate all your costs, so that way you know how much money you need to save. Then you're gonna decide, you're gonna come up with a buy date. What I mean by that, what year do I want to purchase a house? Is it 2 years from now? Is it 3 years from now? Is it 5 years from now? Is it a year from now? So let's say, so you're gonna come up with a buy date. Let me get done with this, and then I'm gonna go back and give like an example, okay? So that way you can kind of understand what I'm saying. So you're gonna come up with a buy date. That means, you know, I need $10,000 by January 2025, or January 2023, or January 2024. Okay, so then you're gonna divide the payments up by the year. So if I need $10,000 in a year, so what I'm gonna do is divide 10,000 by 12, because that's 12 months. If I need $10,000 in 2 years, I'm gonna divide $10,000 in 24. If I need $10,000 in 3 years, you get where I'm going with this, okay? So calculate how much money you need. If you need $20,000, if you need it in a year, 12 months, divided by 12. If you need it in 3 years, you divide it by 36, okay? And that gives you your monthly payment. So you can calculate your monthly payment of how much money you need to save every month, how much money you need to put into account. In an account, oh, how much money you need to put in an account every month, okay? So, like I said, example. So, I need $20,000 in 2 years. This is going to help me get my closing costs, my insurance, my earnest money, anything else that I need, any type of fees. And I want to purchase a $250,000 house, but I need $20,000. So what I'm going to do is I want this in 24 months, which is 2 years. So I'm going to take $20,000 divided by 24, and that would give me $833.33. So what I did, I just rounded $833.50. So I need to put $833.50 in the bank every month for 2 years, and that's going to give me my $20,000. Let's say I want to save $20,000 in 5 years. You do the same thing. $20,000 divided by 60 months, because 60 months is 5 years, and then that would give me $333.33. So round it off, $333.50. You're gonna save $333.50 in the bank every month for 24 months, or 60 months, I'm sorry. You're gonna save $333.50 for 60 months, and that will give you your $20,000. Now, make sure you put your dream money in a high yield checking account. I always tell people that, because these are your, you're gonna save this money for 2, 3, or 4, or 5 years, or how many years you got out. So it's gonna accrue interest. So that's why we're putting it in a high yield savings or checking account. It doesn't matter if you want it, whichever one has the highest interest rate. You want to check the savings interest rate, you want to check the checking interest rate, and whichever one has the highest interest rate, that's where you want to deposit your money, okay? Now, don't buy stocks with this money. A lot of people think that they can put this money in stocks. No, stocks are for long term. Stocks are for anything from 5 to 10 or 15 or 20 to 30 years. If you're needing this money in less than 5 years, then you don't want to put it in a stock account, because it's going to penalty you if you try to take it out, and you don't want that. You don't want to lose the money that you gain. So put it in a high yield checking account. That way is you can get it. If you need it in an emergency, if something happens, you know, death in the family, and you don't have the money and you really need the money, then it's liquid. You can go to the bank and say, hey, I need to withdraw my money out. So remember that. Do not put your savings in a stock account because it's gonna penalty you if you try to get it out. All right, guys, that's all I have. If you have any questions, I am here. Let's start saving for that dream so that way we can get to this 24 weeks. By the time we get done, we got all the steps, we got everything we need, we got our money saved. Let's go, guys. We can do this, okay? 724. This is your girl, Anjanette Curry, with PBS Financial Coaching and Services. I am here. I'm available. Reach out. We're trying to do this, okay? This is your dream. You need to be serious about it because I am. I want to buy a house, so I am disciplining myself to get that house, and I'm going to do whatever it takes. So come along, guys. Join the journey with me. Let's do this. Let's make our dreams come true.